and it's the man from Mauritius, Cedric Codets, to get underway. And you might have noticed that with him there, supporting him, Roelia Ranavalosia, who actually won a silver medal in the 49 kilo women's competition. That's his girlfriend. Now the bar is at 130 kilos for the first lift of this competition. Well, always good to start with, as they say, a good lift.
Off the floor. It's a small technical error, but it's enough just to send him onto his toes and he walks forwards. But other than that, not bad. The body weights are going up. These guys are sub 96 kilos in body weight. And you're going to see some tremendous power and strength demonstrated in this category.
So these are big guys, but they also have nerves.
What's most impressive as well is they all get into very, very good positions. For those of you watching for the first time, you'll see the deep squat position with a bar overhead. So this first discipline that we're looking at is called the snatch. Bar must go from the floor overhead in one continuous movement. It must also abide by certain rules. We'll tell you about those as and when they happen.
Australia, Ridge Barredo, combines his weightlifting with his day job as a psychiatric nurse. That's quite a testing combination. Now he's asked to open up here on 135 kilos. Well, it was a long way away.
It's a long way away because that's exactly where the bar was. It was a long way away. We noticed the shoulders whip back as he passes the knees, and that kicks the bar out. There's a huge swing on the bar. Ideally, you want that swing to finish directly overhead, but in this case, it's finished out in front. Not the opening lift that Ridge would have hoped for. Still got two attempts remaining, and he's clearly strong enough.
Yeah, he was eighth in the Commonwealth Games 4 years ago. That was at 105 kilos, so he's come down to this 96 kilo class. But talking to him, he said he feels pretty comfortable at this weight.
Well, he looks good, he looks lean. It's all very well being heavy, but if you're just carrying additional body weight that's not muscle, it's not much use. Often when a lifter trims up and slims down, you find that they're a lot faster as well. Good thing about this sport is it's fully inclusive, regardless of your size, there's a category for you.
So the bar to 136 kilos, possibly for Cedric Corrette of Mauritius. Just indeed, here he comes. Only 40 seconds and he's got to get all the way up the ramp.
Well, he'll be fully aware of how long he has. Directly ahead of him as he walks up now, there is a scoreboard, big TV with the time clock, so he knows he's only got 30 seconds. He won't waste time, but at the same time, he won't rush. Doesn't want that heart rate spiking before the lift.
Ten seconds.
He's okay. He's getting instructions from the side.
Well, a little skew whiff, but it's there.
Well, squiffy as you like, it stuck overhead, and that was really good teamwork. His girlfriend on the side, just shouting out how many seconds he had left, so he didn't need to waste the time looking up. He was fully under control. may have seemed to us like he was on the edge of the time. Well, he was. He only had a couple of seconds left.
So, Ridge, at 136 kilos, he's gone up a kilo, not bothering that he failed at 135. Strong enough for this. That's what we wanted to see first time around.
And the shake of the head says it all. Not happy with the opening lift. He's going to feel as though that was a waste. His progress now in the competition is limited. Drops his chest, whips the shoulders back, flicks the hips forward. Big swing on the bar, could do with ironing that problem out. But you know what, it's so hard when a lifter has got an ingrained movement pattern, just to make the subtlest of tweaks can be so hard and take many months to do.
Ruben Berger for South Africa. Alongside him, Peter Kartev, his coach. They've been a partnership, friends for 5.5 years together. Used to be involved in athletics, throwing the javelin, but switched to weightlifting about 6 years ago. National record holder of his country. Well, another disappointing start there.
Very soft underneath the bar. I'd like to see a bit more explosion, a bit more speed dropping under. Technically not bad, the bar's following a good line, it's just a little bit soft into the receiving position. Here we want to see powerful extension, but speed to the bottom, and at the moment he's trying to catch it high and ride it in.
So our numbers, as you'll see, they are in electrical, they're almost like an F1.
It's interesting, I'm watching Peter, his coach, backstage there. You can see him working with a towel, just suggests that the heat might be just building backstage there a little bit. Now, 138. Is he going to come out and take the second attempt? It's looking that way. So here we go. 140 is his national record for the snatch. So he's starting here just 2 kilos short of that.
This is a big ask, and it's a pressurized lift, David. He needs to make this. He doesn't want to find himself coming out for a third attempt. This has got to be sharper than the first. Stay on balance.
Yeah.
Just drifted forwards there, drops the chest, goes round his knees quite a long way. And that swing, he managed to control overhead. Very, very strong in the shoulders to stabilise under the bar. Thank goodness, says the coach. He's like, I'm okay, come on, give me some more kilos. It wasn't heavy enough, that's the problem.
Bar going up. Just to put a little perspective on the first part of the competition, Don Opalogi of Samoa, who was a silver medalist 4 years ago, he's posted 165 kilos for his opening snatch. So I just wanted to put that in perspective as to where we are now at 140.
That's right, and let's put it further in perspective. Cyril Chet of England, he's the next highest starter with a significant 1-5-4. So there's a huge gap between openers. It's going to be an interesting competition to see how this unfolds.
And the clock stops and we change again. So Rich Barredo proposed at 140, but the Aussies changed it again. 142 they've gone to.
For those of you new to the sport, yes, there's a competition on the platform, but a lot of the competition starts backstage at this table. It's at this desk that the coaches will make all the weight nominations.
And the result of that little early chess game is that Cedric Corrette has to come out for his third attempt at 141 kilos. So Cedric, first attempt, good at 130, then 136, and now he's going for a personal best. And this is 141, which is actually a 3 kilo personal best. Come on. Well, it's there. It may not be the kind of the most elegant, but he's managed to get the three white lights.
I think that's a wonderful lift. Three from three on a big competition platform. He let the emotions out as he stepped backstage. Right now, it was complete focus. That is brilliant lifting.
Always encouraging and good to see a lifter complete a sequence, but that's only the first half of the competition for him, as Rich Barredo now comes out to try 142 kilos. This is some way short of what he has done in the past, which is over 150 kilos.
Before it took the clock out, there's no protection for the clock. Okay, so again, once again, we have that flick of the hips and a lean of the back. That's the technical problem. You can see here, he's trying to get out of the way, and the bar was heading straight for the corner. Not the tidiest of lifts technically, and he'll have to be content with just the 1 out of 3 on the board. 136 is the weight that he's stuck on.
And I think he maybe cut his hand, because the loaders have taken the bar off the platform and are hygienically cleaning it. And
that's okay, a torn callus, David, a bit of chalk. Fill it in with chalk and it'll stop bleeding.
There are the loaders who I believe were trying to entice you last night.
I got hijacked. I'm walking back to my hotel. Do you know what? I was chatting to them and they said, I said, how are you feeling? I said, fair play, you're running up and down on the platform. 14.5 miles was the distance one of them covered, just running up and down on the platform, and we've got to give them some credit. The
I'll give them a lot of it.
UK Armed Forces have been brilliant.
As ever. So Ruben Berger, 143 for his third attempt. Got the 138, now the 143. So going for a new personal's best and a new national record for South Africa in this class. He is the national champion at this weight. Not to be on this occasion.
No, in my view, just a little bit too slow underneath the bar. You've got to be dropping and catching that bar, not placing it and riding it in, which is what we're seeing here. Very, very strong. Just needs to be a bit quicker. Unfortunately, just left back with the one successful lift, 138.
even at this early stage of the competition, these failures here and there could be mighty important, because I can see already at least two different fights, perhaps one for the gold and silver and the other one for the bronze.
I'm tempted to say even gold medal potentially is there to be lost for Dan Opalogi. We've got a good fight on for the bronze, definitely, and right now we've got a sprint for the platform. Doesn't need to run, he's got plenty of time, still over 30 seconds on the clock. What you don't want to do is panic your lifter like's just happened, so the lifter heart rate has just spiked. Now he's got to try and control his breathing and bring his nerves back down.
Right. 5 kilos in excess of his personal best in his first Commonwealth Games. Dennis Asama for the Cameroon. Well, good lift. Waits for the signal to put the bar back down on the platform. Duly rewarded.
Yeah, and coming out 5 kilos above your best, well, that's above his best in competition. I'm only assuming he's done more than this in training. That's a really solid opener. Very confident lift. And considering the preparation he had, if you remember, he just ran up onto the platform. So hopefully the next one will be a little more composed.
Yeah, Dennis, the African champion of last season, actually snatched 156 kilos on his way to that particular gold medal. Been quite a consistent performer. He's also achieved a silver medal in the African Games in 2019 in Rabat.
The changes of weights here coming from Cyprus, coming from Ghana as well.
Yeah, Forrester Osei of Ghana. Interesting having a chat to him. He was really up and made a point of saying, I'm here to fight for a medal.
Well, I tell you what's just happened here. You can see the discussions going on there at the table. The lifter from the Cameroon that we've just seen, Dennis Asama, he's just had the 145 successful lift. The bar automatically went to 146. They failed to change the weight before the clock ran 30 seconds. We're now sub 30 seconds on a 2-minute clock. Their lifter is not budging.
No, and the clock continues to...
Well, he needs to scoot now, get a sprint on this time.
He's not going to make this.
No way.
Now,
13 seconds on the clock. He's got to be close to Usain Bolt's time, I'd say, over 30 metres to get to the platform.
Even better
in time.
Than that, no. Forget it, he said. He's realised it.
He's like, I'm not making that.
Yeah.
And that's a
this again is a coaching mistake.
It's a huge coaching mistake, and the coach is really right now, after the lifter has lifted the bar, they have one job to do. Get the weight change in before the clock runs 30 seconds. Very, very simple job. And instead they get drawn into the competition. You don't need three coaches hanging around a lifter asking for the weight change. Just get to the table and make a change. So they've gone up now to 150.
Well, I'll tell you, whilst you're looking at the Indian who's about to come out here, the Lotus were absolutely fantastic changing the weights. But this is Vikas Thakur, one of the most experienced men in this afternoon's competition. This his third Commonwealth Games. Well, he's won a silver, he's won a bronze, hails from the Punjab, and naturally, gold is on his mind. So, opening up here on 149 kilos. that's a decent start, and at his best, he's worth 159 kilos.
Really? That's a really good opener, 149. Very solid, very convincing. Good extension, powerful extension, which drives the bar upwards overhead. The key here is to have the bar moving upwards as the body is transitioning under.
So you'll see the first lift on a weightlifting competition is very important. The coaches have to pick the right weight to enable the lifters to have a solid platform.
So the first appearance of the man all the way from Suva in Fiji, Taniela Arani Bongi. 150 kilos in this, his second Commonwealth Games. Still, finally gets the put down light, and that's okay.
You see how hard he has to work in the squat position, fighting the body shaking. The steps forward don't matter, so long as he stays on the platform and brings his feet back in line, demonstrating control.
Interesting, he's moved up from 4 years ago, from 85 to this category, 96.
Well, he's a tall guy, and you know, even in this category, he looks tall and could probably easily go up again if wanting to.
Antonis Matasidis from Cyprus. As I mentioned in the introduction, he used to represent Greece, but in 2015 changed his allegiance to Cyprus, although home for him is actually still in Athens. There's a friendly arrangement between the Greeks and the Greek Cypriots in terms of their lifters. It's also interesting, he is by some way the lightest man, sub 90 kilos he weighed in at.
Yeah, and a few years ago that would have, could have played a big part, but right now, as long as they've made the category, that's the only thing body weights are looked at. Body weights from there on are irrelevant, so you could look at it, yes, he's the lightest, but he's actually giving away body weight, and what that means is that those he's competing against are carrying more muscle and therefore should be stronger.
Nonetheless, an encouraging opener there with 150 kilos. And now the scoreboard looking a little bit healthier after those successes in the last couple of minutes. So Dennis Osama of the Cameroon, due to come out, but 152 on the bar. Now, of course, he succeeded at 145, and then they messed up on the timing, and 146 went by the wayside, and so this is a 7 kilo increase. And he's got 20 seconds from now. He's not happy with that, to only get one out of three, Mikada.
No, he needs a little bit more spark. He's way on his toes as the bar comes past his knee. I don't think the bar was even in contact with the body. Really, the bar should be pretty much in contact with shins, knees, thighs before the lifter explodes, and that was a long way forward.
Bar going to 153 kilos now. Clock counting down for the first appearance of Forrester Osei. Well, this is interesting. He originally posted 140 for his opener, and this is 153. So, a little psychology, I fancy, going on here. from South London, Crystal Palace, which is where he trains.
Well, he never really set the start position at all then. It was like he rushed it coming off the floor. Nice to see Keith Morgan in his corner from Crystal Palace. Take a look here, head was never up, shoulders were down. Rushed it, not enough extension, not enough height on the bar. Well, Forrester, you've got some work to do here. Let's hope he can come back on his next lift.
Well, he did say to me he was here for a medal. He can't make any more mistakes like that. Well, here's our friend from India, Vikas Thakur. He said to me when he was having a little rest getting ready for the competition, in his weightlifting career, he's been to 26 countries around the world, but he still loves the Punjab best of all. One, five, three, second attempt. 4 kilo increase. That's better than the first. Building confidence,
and he's really pumped here. Still one attempt to go. There's a few more kilos in the tank, possibly. Really good extension, good speed under the bar. Notice he lands at the bottom as the bar hits the lowest point as well, so they stand together. There's no huge impact. Come on.
There's Keith Morgan on the left of your picture there. Now, Forrester. This is the office. Now. I know it's early in the competition, Mikhailo, but he's got to make this.
He has. This is a pressurized lift. Missed the first one. Needs this. Lifter under pressure. Come on, Forrester, you've got to find some legs in this. There's simply not enough height on the bar. You've got to create enough upward momentum to get underneath it. And at the moment, the bar is nowhere near high enough. One to go, big pressure. Let's hope the crowd get behind him.
Yeah, because should he not succeed next time around, it will rule him out of the competition.
And I remember on an occasion way back in the day being in exactly the same position, having missed two attempts with Keith Morgan in my corner as national coach. I think it was preceded with a few very stern words and a slap around the cheeks, and then went out and got it. Let's see if Keith can have the same influence here.
Interestingly, Forrester just recently was elected chair of the International Weightlifting Federation's Athletes Commission. So, job with some responsibility. It actually gives him a position on the executive board. He won't be thinking about that now, but there are those nice polite words from Keith Morgan.
No, I tell you what, it's a good job Keith's facing the other way. Well, Keith, a very, very experienced platform coach. He's coached many athletes on the international stage. Well, come on, listen to the roar of the crowd.
Well, the thousands behind us, and I do mean thousands, are all on his side at this moment. Come on, Forrester.
Oh, desperately disappointing. Three from three, no lifts. He's bombed out and unfortunately will take no further part here in these Commonwealth Games. Keith Morgan, if he did have any hair left, well, that's all gone. Again, once again, just not enough height on the bar. I fear he's probably come out too heavy here. Remember, it's a rising bar, so the lifters, the coaches will choose when their athlete comes in.
Well, this was what I pointed out. He posted 140. He came out on 153. Never mind. We move straight on to England, Cyril Tchatchett, who used to live for the Cameroon. He did so at the Commonwealth Games in 2014. He then... Well, let's concentrate on the lift. It's a long story, but we hopefully got plenty of time to tell it. 154, first attempt for England. Well done, Cyril. Lives in this part of the world now, Walsall in the West Midlands.
See here, pretty good off the floor, just tips forwards a little bit, has to correct by throwing the shoulders back, that causes him a lack of extension, but he's powerful enough to get the upward height on the bar, and claps all round from the English coaches.
Controller should have just held Taniela back a little bit before letting him prowl around the place. But Taniela Ranibongi for Fiji. Second attempt at 155. 150 to start. That was good. This is a 5 kilo increase. That for me was better than the first one.
Yes, it was. This is a man full of confidence, full of adrenaline, and every ounce of that adrenaline is being fired into focused aggression here. Brilliant technique, great extension. He's a tall guy. That is a long way for the bar to travel. He generates his force in the right directions, gaining maximum upward momentum. Brilliant lifting.
Of course, Fiji, well known for their superstar performances in rugby sevens, and I was talking to his coach Henry Elder about the fact that he might have gone for rugby sevens, and he went, no way, no way. So Antonis Matasidis started on 150. That was a good attempt. He's taking the same weight increase for the Cypriot. But he was going for a weight that he's never lifted on a competition stage.
Here is a place to do it. Well, this is called the snatch, but to me, he snatched it off the floor, came off a little bit too aggressive and lost the position. That bar just drifted forwards. Very, you know, I'm being really super fussy here technically, but I'm trying to point out the reasons why these bars are going to ground, because these guys are definitely strong enough for the weights we're seeing, but it's got to be technically executed correctly as well.
So, Vikas, a warrant officer in the Indian Air Force, which enables him to essentially full-time train. The Indians, who came to Birmingham a full month before these games to settle in. And as he was saying to me, loads of people that he knows from the Punjab who live in this part of the world. So he's had a lot of socialising to do, as well as preparations. Oh, it's getting better and better, isn't it?
Celebrations say it all. Wonderful experience here. Three from three. Can't do any more than that.
He's lifted well, and I think intelligently. He's got a 159, but he's probably done the wise thing for just making sure that he gets the 155 in the first part. Now, Matasidis, well, to stay in contention, really needs this. This is the man with the light body weight, sub 90 kilos. Yeah. 10 seconds. 5. Well, you can see by the manner that he walked off the stage, really disappointed.
Drifting around the knees again, once more. Really good extension, good lift, good speed, good strength. Just fractionally forwards.
So it should be Cyril Chachet, the second for England. So, basically, competed in the Games in Glasgow in 2014, then was fearful about going back to the Cameroons, so he didn't. He became homeless, he lost all his identity, he ended up competing for the refugee team in the Olympics in Tokyo, but finally this year got that British passport. That's the short version.
Some wonderful lifting that we are witnessing right now, and it's being able to bring your A game to the platform when it really matters. And that's exactly what we're seeing here. 2 from 2. 1 attempt remaining. How many more kilos does he have?
Well, that was a 2 kilo personal best. He's a very engaging guy. As I said, he now is based in Walsall in the West Midlands, although his weightlifting club is technically still Middlesex University. He's a mental health nurse, very bright guy, Cyril, and the speed of this competition is impressive at the moment. It's really moving apace as we see Daniela Arrainibonghi going for 160 to try and make it 3 out of 3. This would be a 10 kilo personal best.
It's close. So he originally posted a 142 as his opener. He actually came out 150, then hit the 155 for a big personal best. This was monumental. Too much of a swing backwards. Not quite the technique and the precision we saw on the foot on the previous lift. Just trying that a little bit harder. He nearly had it. It was at arm's length.
So the bar going over 160 kilos to 161. Now, the standard, the Commonwealth Games standard, is 159. So this is a record attempt for Don Opologhi, 23 years of age, following in the footsteps of Eli Opologhi and Musila Opologhi, who won Commonwealth Golds in Delhi in 2010. And many, many more medals for the Opologhis, which we'll get to in time. First attempt, 161. Well, it's pretty well the start we expected.
Our first one is on the board, and that's a nice little lead he's just established there with just one lift. A little bit of an arm pull, but good leg drive. Super fast under the bar. The lifter in good shape by the looks of it, with still 2 attempts to go. This lead can only extend.
What I think's really interesting is the fact that the whole Samoan weightlifting federation was locked down for 2 years. They weren't able to go to Tokyo. They were denied by their government the release to travel. So that's why this is such an important competition. And in fact, it's only 3 weeks ago that the government released them to be able to come to the Commonwealth Games. But back to Cyril Chachet. So far, so good for himself and England. 154, 158, now 162. Yeah. who's trying a new mark on the competition stage.
That was a gutsy performance, a really gutsy effort. It would have kept him up there in contention, just throws his shoulders back, doesn't get enough leg extension. Really exciting prospect for England. Super happy to hear he's managed to get himself a passport.
Well, it was absolutely the right thing to do. It was a go at the games record, but more importantly, he was actually trying to make sure that he stayed close to this man. So Don Opelogi already has 161. Cyril Chachet the second on 158, his closest pursuer. Now it's all about how many more kilos this man can accumulate. Second attempt, there it is.
For 5 kilos up, so the 3 kilo lead now becomes 8. And he's still got one to go, sharp underneath the bar. That's what you need, that kind of speed. Really strong off the floor, but lightning fast, hitting extension to dropping under.
Commonwealth Games silver medalist 4 years ago and up in weight category for Don, and this will be a new personal best attempt in respect of his performances so far at 96 kilos. Incidentally, his brother Jack is going tomorrow in the 109 kilos, so there'll be more Opelogi action, so to speak.
Well, he's going big, up 5 kilos to 171.
Well, this is a lift which is all about just disappointing your opposition, just sending them a message. Hey guys, if you're going to come out, think about silver and bronze, because I'm going to take the gold.
It's a real shame that Bodhi Santavi was unable to compete due to injury. We wish him a speedy recovery, but it does make for an exciting head-to-head come the Olympic Games.
Yeah, and that's what Bodhi's got to concentrate on now, getting ready for Paris 2024. So, a comfortable minute for Don to prepare to take this second effort. And the crowd really getting excited as Don piles on the weight. Obviously, if he does achieve this, it'll be yet another Commonwealth Games record. And he is, I remind you, only 23. Kilos.
There's nothing really to say here other than congratulations, Don. That was outstanding lifting. Knees nearly collapsed in, managed to maintain it. Fantastic to watch.
Well, that's what, 13 kilos ahead of his closest pursuer. And that's Cyril Chachet the second for England.
So that concludes the snap session, but please stay tuned as we continue to
Whatever happens now, when we go into the second half of the competition, everybody will be looking with an anticipation as to what Don Opelogi is going to try to do. But it does suggest, to be honest, as we lead. But then look at Chachet the second, is only 3 kilos ahead of Rani Bongi of Fiji and Takur. They're both on 155. Martasidis, well, he lost two attempts there at 150. If he'd been 155, he'd be in the mix, but he's still not out of the bronze medal chase, and neither necessarily is Dennis Asama, but the Cameroon coaching has got to improve. The big disappointment, of course, is for Ghana, with Forrest Osei failing to get a good lift. So, let's have a look at the successes and one or two failures from the first half of the competition. There, the lifts of, or I should say, the first attempts for the clean and jerk. And of course, the time here in Birmingham just after 3 o'clock. So the platform is ready, the bar is loaded. 160 kilos for Cedric Corrette for Mauritius. Cedric. Three good lifts, but 141 kilos. Having said that, the last of the successful snatch attempts represented a new personal best. His heaviest weight in competition in this 96 kilo category, 176. Starting at 160, not really sure he's going to get that close to a PB attempt. 10 seconds. Well, it's there. And Paulette Mikaela described the various improvements that need to be made.
Well, I'm not sure it is there, to be honest. The clean was fine. Jerk to me was okay, but it just seemed like he was shaking so much. The question is, did his arms come out of lock? Jerk. I thought the elbows were a little bit shaky. Let's take a close look here.
Shaky.
I
thought that was all right, to be honest.
Yeah, I mean, I was looking at it thinking, ooh, that's a bit soft. But there has been a raise of the flag from the jury. They are just taking a review on this. We just have to hang on for their decision. I thought it was okay, but I'm not the referee and I'm not the jury. So we'll take another look. Again, the clean is absolutely fine.
Let's just have a look at this and then I'm going to explain something.
Yeah, so the rule is the arms must go to lock and stay there, no movement in the elbows. This to me is just shaking. There's no press out as such. Let's see what the jury make of it. The decision is coming.
I was going to say, when the jury look at it, if you're the president of the jury, dead centre, looking dead head on at the television screen, it's one thing. But the others are all looking clustered around from an angle.
Oh, really?
Oh, come on.
So the announcement has just come through. It's irrelevant what we think. It's down to the referees, and in this case, the jury have stepped in, and they've said no lift.
Yeah, I'd like to know the reason for that.
Well,
it's
going to be arms, it's going to be press out, but we've just seen it. I've said my piece. I'm not the one to make the decision.
Well, for once, we agree.
It doesn't happen very often, does it?
Not. I feel a bit sad and sorry for him, to be honest.
I do. I think that was a pretty harsh decision.
So, inevitably, he finds himself in a situation here where, really, he's going to have to follow himself.
Incredible learning team, and also, as you heard,
we go again. Another look at this. Press out or shaking under the strain of the weight? I'll let you be the judge.
Well, I think that's shaking.
Maybe that's the rule that needs to be clarified. I'm personally all for keeping the press out rule. I think it makes lifters be really sharp technically. But that is, there's a difference between shaking under the strain and clearly pressing out.
Yeah, I think that was a tough call. Anyway, as you rightly said, it's been decided, so on we go. He just has to put that out of his mind, and he's got two more attempts. It's going to help him if he really executes the first phase economically.
No, that's a no lift. That's a press out.
Yeah, I would agree. On that left arm, that was really clear.
And this is really unfortunate. He's now in a position with two failed lifts. Has to make the next lift to stay in the competition to make a total and get the position. Here we see a power clean, just shows how powerful and strong he is. Power clean, by definition, means catching above a 90-degree knee bend. Watch the elbows, drives, now they bend. That's dodgy.
Okay, Stu.
Yeah, but that was a definite press out.
Maybe he was just educating everybody the difference between a wobble and a press out. Am I allowed to say that?
Well, these guys have worked hard for years and years and years. They've travelled a long way. They deserve accurate judging. And so I really hope that this last attempt, he's going to succeed and there'll be no sort of doubt about the quality of the lift. Now, he's got just over a minute, so he'll be out on stage momentarily.
And the problem here, David, is he's already expended a significant amount of energy. Coming out onto the platform and lifting a near maximum weight will take a lot out of you.
Well, look at him, he's still breathing heavily. You can see the sweat on his brow. It
2 minutes recovery, and that's all the lifters. It's not even 2 minutes, it's a 2 minute clock, but they have to start the lift before the clock runs to zero. So it's barely, what, a minute 30 recovery they have. And you can see he's still blowing very heavily.
Right. This to achieve a total and stay alive in the competition and get a ranking position. Okay, that's for me is the best of the three cleans. And that surely is okay.
I thought that was worse than the first one.
Did you?
Yep, but he's got it 2-1. Let's see if the jury are going to sit tight or are they going to raise the flag. Well, they're leaving it go by the looks of it. So he's got a lift on the board with some, well, questionable decisions.
Well, you have a look at it again. At the end of those three attempts, I think justice has been done. But
yeah, I think so. I mean, we're not the referee, we're not the jury, we're just here chatting. But ultimately, I think the first jerk I thought was a good one. This one, we need the head on angle. I don't know if we'll get it. We'll see. Here we go. Here's right arm, our left as we see it. Let's see what happens. Bend, straighten. There's the press out. That's more movement than we saw on the first lift. Anyway, I'm glad he's got that because I think that's put the wrongs to right.
So now Ruben Berger for South Africa. Only made one successful snatch attempt, so only bringing forward 138 kilos. So let's see what he can do with the clean and jerk. Opening up here on 165, 10 kilos below his personal best. Well, finally gets it all together.
Well, he's had a few minutes waiting backstage and a few minutes longer than he would have anticipated. He would have been ready after the previous lifter's first attempt. A bit short on the extension on the clean. It does enough to get it to shoulders. And jerk dips and drives, bar over shoulders, shoulders over hips. Little arch in the lower back, that's fine.
So, totals up 303 kilos, goes into first place. Cedric Corredo of Mauritius finishing on 301. So to Australia and Rich Barredo. Again, another man who only got one out of three in the first half of the competition, so it really limits his possibilities. So 170, the beginning of his journey to try and catch up as much as possible. With the remaining two attempts.
Let's have a look here. Clean hits him quite hard. He's got good legs to stand. There's a few more kilos there. Take a look at the back foot sticking out to the side. I'm not a fan of that. I've seen a lifter dislocate a kneecap. Ideally, back foot wants to be pointing forward. That looks all right to me, David. I think he's got a few more kilos there. He wants to keep around all 171 kilograms for Ruben Berger, South Africa, second attempt.
Send that joke, Barry. You're doing well, mate. It's good to see you again, the annual platform. So, you heard him. Send him. Ruben. Into. Take his second attempt now at
1 straight in.
2-1 against, so the lift is not given.
No, and I wouldn't disagree with that.
And I can see that, in fact, Peter Kartev is playing the challenge card.
Yeah, and I think this is a wise decision. Let's take a look here. He dips low, drives. The arms are not straight, but they don't straighten, they just stay bent. I think that's a good lift. It's not a great lift, ideally you want the arms locked, but the rule is so long as there is no movement in the elbows. I didn't think there was movement in the elbows.
And just for those of you who might not be familiar, the challenge card, every coach has one challenge card which they can use during the competition if they disagree with the decision of either the referees or the jury. And Robert Rose from the Seychelles, the technical controller, now on his way back.
Yeah, I know. I think it's easier for us to see that this is not going to be upheld. The no lift, I think, is going to stand because the jury have withheld their challenge card. So this was, again, a questionable decision. I'll let you at home have the discussion about it. Was it a press out? I think he just held it on bent arms.
Well, that's a definite setback for the South African. So, 171 kilos on the bar at the moment. And the bar changes now to 175 kilos being loaded potentially for the lifter from the Cameroon, Dennis Essawa.
There's a change of course.
Well, the lifter from the Cameroon has increased his opening weight to 180, so that effectively has forced Ruben Berger to come out to take his third and final attempt for 175.
But he's got to refocus now. This is a big lift. He does have one on the board, but you know, he would like to go that bit further, wouldn't he?
Oh, absolutely. I mean, he's well short of where he wanted to be, and he's only made two good lifts so far. Absolutely not the competition he came to deliver.
No, a disappointing end to Ruben Bergner's campaign. Ends with a 303 total. Let's see what happened. Clean, tip forwards a little bit, caused a lack of extension, but still good. Really strong in the clean phase. He's a tall guy, long distance to drive the bar overhead. Here we'll see the hips are behind the bar, trying to compensate with the shoulders. Not to be today.
Well, the truth is, Michaela, that he'd only got two good lifts. Even if he got this, he would have had only three out of six. And on those percentages, you're never going to win a medal and you're never going to get a high-ranking position.
I know, but this is very much about personal goals. And, you know, he's going to be disappointed having not achieved those.
Come on, then, Berger, let's come to the beach.
So, I must say, the Cameroon coaching team have a methodology of their own, really. I'm not sure it's necessarily the best one, but this is Dennis Asama, 180 kilos, first attempt. Just moves the arms out to make the distance shorter and succeeds.
Succeeds with style, he does. First one on the board, he's got a total, he's got a strong total. But he wants more, the coaching staff want more from him. Fast under the bar on the clean. Takes a moment to compose, adjust the grip. Look how wide that grip is. Less distance for the bar to travel, makes the jerk easier. That's okay if you have the mobility to do so.
So Dennis Asama for the Cameroon goes into the lead with 3:25. Rich Barredo finds himself now in second place. And this is a 10-kilo increase. So this is a chunky challenge he's taking on here.
Yeah. I don't know. I think the tattoo is nicely disguising his left elbow. But the referees were not fooled. We'll take a look at the jerk again. I saw press out there in the left elbow.
Jury flag.
Well, they want to take another look at it, that's fine. But I think once they take a look at it, they will also see what we saw, or what I saw.
So the jury stopped the competition. Once again, I explained the jury can stop with all the technical control. We'll just wait to see what their decision is.
So the lift, as we can see here, is under review from the jury. That meant they weren't in agreement with the decision. So they want to take another look. The tattoo sleeve kind of disguises what's happened here. Well, I think that's straight now. It wasn't straight when he received it. But then me and the jury have not been seeing eye to eye this competition, so it's their decision that's the important one. Sorry, guys. Also, we've had the decision. It's a good lift, apparently.
So, 181 kilograms on the run, please.
well, there it is, and Mikhaila just sort of shaking her head here, because what we're looking for, whether it's from the referees or indeed from the jury, is consistency. Accuracy and consistency.
I'm going to keep myself out of trouble and not say any more.
Well, the bar's going to 185 kilos for Taniela Rainibongi. Once again, technical controller not really doing what he should do, which is to keep the lifter back from the platform until it's ready. But the imposing figure of the Fijian, I should say, doesn't matter that he's rotated a little bit. That looks, from our angle, okay to me.
It really was okay. That was a super solid jerk. And if the lifter does twist and turn, it's absolutely fine. They can perform the jerk facing backwards if they want. In some ways, it actually goes in a lifter's favour, because then the referees don't get a good view of the arms. There's no way we could assess this if we had to. Really solid lifting, first attempt.
And deservedly, Taniela Rainibongi has gone into the lead. So Fiji leading from the Cameroon and Australia, but now Cyril Chachet the second for England, coming out for his first attempt on 185. Lying in second place in the silver medal position at the halfway stage. You could see the bar went forward and the hips went back, and he is in trouble.
He landed that really, really well. What's he done here? Oh no, he's in trouble, is he?
I think he is in trouble.
I didn't see, forgive me, I didn't see what happened there. I turned to look at you, David. Let's have a look here. So the clean was good. I thought the jerk was pretty good as well, but then as he recovered, the hips went backwards. I'm just wondering if he's hurt his elbow. No, he's okay there. What happened? Was he just passed out maybe? Maybe gone dizzy, lightheaded? The bar didn't hit him or anything on the way down. It was as he started to walk away. I think he's gone dizzy, you know. Be okay, get the bell tongue done, get a whiff of the smelling salts. Stu Martin in his face telling him he's fine. He'll be okay. It's a tremendous strain these guys are under. Substantial weights here, 185 kilos at 96 kilo body weight. You stand up with a heavy clean, and it's quite common for the lifter to feel dizzy with the bar on their shoulders.
So he's not going to get any help here, because nobody else wants this weight.
Just getting
really?
Sorry, we've got the physio here. I think he's physio, forgive me, I don't know. Just getting into his lats, trying to loosen them off. I'm just wondering whether it might also be a touch of cramp.
Either way. A minute remaining on this second attempt.
And they'll use it. They'll probably keep him backstage and for another 10, 20 seconds or so. He's got plenty of time.
Absolutely right. Yeah, he does not need to rush.
Needs this lift, this for a potential medal.
Drives up for the clean, but it wasn't easy, but it's there. He'll slide the hands out. There you go.
Oh dear, Cyril Chachet is in trouble. He's not comfortable, something is giving him some problem.
Well, he's managed to rush off to get treatment because he knows that he's going to have to follow himself again.
I think his lats are cramping. Looks to be in the back. So I'm not too worried about the position. If he can just deal with the discomfort, whatever it is he's struggling with, he's got a chance. But this is a lifter now under some serious pressure. Adjustment of the hands to get a better grip. Drives, just doesn't quite get it to arm's length.
And the English coaches have put the weight up to 188 for his third attempt. That's to give them more time.
Yeah, he needs whatever time he can get right now. It's a big risk.
It is a big risk, but I think they thought they really need this amount of time to work on him. And Vikas Thakur for India to come out to take his first attempt. He has got a host of supporters in the stands. As I mentioned, there are lots of relations and friends from the Punjab whose home is in the Midlands, and they've all turned out to see him. Ten seconds as he approaches the bar. Looks at the clock, knows where he is. Gets the clean. Well, 1 second to spare, but the first attempt is A-OK.
I'm not sure why he looked at the clock after the clean. He was fine by then. As long as the lift has passed the knee, or the bar has passed the knees, it's fine. So works hard to stand. The drive overhead was really good, straight to arm's length. Solid as a rock under the bar.
And that takes him straight into the gold medal position for the moment. And this is Dennis Osama on the stage, currently lying in third place. Now, this is a 7 kilo increase. He's on 325. This would take him to 332. Not to be.
7 kilos, big increase.
And that, of course, was his second attempt.
Well, the early arm pulls the chest forwards, doesn't get much in terms of leg extension. It's enough to get under the bar, but it's always forwards. Well, just to give you some heads up as well, we can see just backstage Cyril Chachet from England still getting treatment. It looks to be stretching. He's cramping. I am 99% sure of that. They've been working on the lats, they're working on the forearms. It just seems like his whole upper body is cramping up. And that's commonplace when a lifter has dehydrated, maybe to make weight. But it's not one thing, it's numerous things, and they're doing it on both sides, which to me indicates it's not a specific injury.
Well, he weighed in at 95.90, inside the 96 kilo limit. And the bar has gone to 188. Well, that's the second attempt, but that's so Taniela Rainibungi for Fiji, currently lying in second place. 3 kilo increase to take him to 343. To put him by a kilo into first place at the moment.
Wow!
Wow! some effort to stand up with that. I couldn't possibly tell you if that's okay from the angle we're looking at. But 2-1 in his favour at the moment.
There's pointless the jury even taking a review. Because he turned sideways, they won't get a good picture. Let's have a look at this. Lands the clean. Well, let's just do a bunny hop. This is a different type of plyometrics to what we're used to. But he readjusts the feet before standing. Because he's turned. Now we need to switch to our side camera, don't we? Good drive overhead, seems to be fine, and there's no way the referees or the jury can overrule a press out when he's in that position.
So this is the moment of truth, really, for Cyril Chache. Has all that work, or is all that work, going to pay off for Cyril? Can he possibly do this? 188. This to get himself back in the medals.
Oh dear. What a shame for Cyril Chache of England. He had every chance of a medal. And it has eluded him today. He will be desperately disappointed. This is more of a technical thing. Pulled the bar onto him, it knocked him backwards. Very hard to recover from that position. What a shame. He's going to be absolutely gutted here.
But it's not the last we're going to see of Cyril Chache the second. This is just the beginning for him and England, and indeed British weightlifting. But out onto the stage comes Dennis Asama, in third place in the bronze medal position. But there are two men who've yet to start, obviously Dom Opelogi, but also Antonis Martasidis of Cyprus.
Collapses with the knee, only the feet allowed to touch the platform.
That was the third attempt, so he is where he is, in third place. And obviously vulnerable.
Yeah, we've got a couple of lifters yet to start their campaign, but he needed this lift to put himself in the best position. And it's not happened, okay, not
so
to be.
Well, mathematically, the men who are in the medals at the moment, Vikas Thakur of India lying in silver, and Dennis Asama of the Cameroon lying in bronze, those are the two men who are mathematically unsafe, if you understand me, can be overtaken. Ridge Barredo. Well, 170, 180, 190. These are big increases. Well, the last Commonwealth Games 4 years ago, he was lifting at 105 kilos. He's come down to 96. He says he feels better for this.
No, he says no, thank you. That's a big jump, 180 to 190, a bit too much for the day.
So the top three stay as they were. The current leader, Taniela Rainibongi for Fiji, currently on 3:43. Now, this is just a 2 kilo increase, so recognizing that he's very much at his limit, this is for a total of 345. And yet another clean and jerk personal best attempt.
Tries to sneak under the bar, it's not going to happen. There's got to be some upward momentum.
Oh.
goes out. Thank you very much to all that have supported. Let's have a look here at the extension. Just not enough extension at knees and hips. He's trying to use the upper body. Power comes from the legs. Got to use the big muscle groups here. Very easy to tug on that bar and try and use everything else, but all you do is take the momentum off.
What a great, great spectacle.
The clock is counting, we're on 37 seconds, but it doesn't look like Antonis Matasidis of Cyprus is coming up. He's gone up in weight by the looks of it. Well, yes, he's coming.
He is coming.
He is coming. And he needs to get a scoot on here. There's 20 seconds remaining on the clock. He'll know that. Weightlifters generally don't move fast unless they're on the bar. Three,
two, one.
Unbelievable.
Timed out.
He knew exactly how long he had, and if he didn't, I just question where his head is at. As you walk up onto the stage, there is a TV screen right ahead of you as you come up that slope with a time on it. As you come onto the platform, there is a clock on the platform. How did he not know the time that was left? You'd have expected as well a shout from the coaches on the sidelines.
Well, that was a completely wasted opportunity by Antonis. And so already out on the stage now, the man who currently lies in second place, and this is Vikas Thakur, every failure making it more likely that he's going to take another Commonwealth Games medal. 191. A 4 kilo increase, and this would take him to 346, and of course would put him into the lead.
Extension to generate the height on the bar. Let's have a look at the jerk. Oh, look at that, hips behind the bar, big arch on the lower back. He does well to recover. He recovers bit by bit. Surely he's going to be on the podium at the end of this.
Well, he deserves to be because it's 6 out of 6. 6 good lifts. Well, Antonin Matasidis is trying to make up for that lost opportunity by putting the bar up to 194 kilos for his second attempt.
Here, Antonis Matasidis from Cyprus. That's the second failure. Timed out on the 191. They've gone up to 194, and that lift was never in his head. And he's in trouble. This is a lifter that has the potential to get in amongst the medals.
And let me make a little correction, an apology. So taken as I am with Vikas Thakur, he's actually got one more attempt. He's got 5 out of 5. With one more to come.
He celebrated as though it was his last one, though. I'll give you that, David.
He did, and maybe that's what fooled me, but He's posted 198 as his third attempt, so, and that would be a 7 kilo increase. So remember, the man who commanded the competition in the first half, Don Opalogi, yet to start. So everybody else is going to finish before he comes in. Well, if he does lift this, he would have 344 kilos, and that would put him into the silver medal position. But on the evidence of what we've seen, there has to be a doubt. But not in his mind. Gets the buzzer out of the way. Not to be, and the top three positions remain India, Fiji, Cameroon.
I'm not sure the word disappointing comes close to describing how he's feeling right now. Timed out and then two lifts like this, didn't even commit to it. He's come out too heavy, doesn't believe it.
I don't think the second half of this competition was ever in his head, to be perfectly honest.
Well,
we have one of these situations at the moment now where there are four men but only three medals. So Vikas to come out and try and lift 198 kilos. Well, this will be quite some lift, because I had 197 as his personal best, and I've just cross-checked that. And so this is for a new personal best, so he's done enough to get a medal.
He's in the lead at the moment. Worst place he can finish is second. This is a personal challenge.
Absolutely.
An attempt at the game's record.
But, hey, worth it. As you said, he celebrated when he got the previous attempt, and he sits there, 3:46. Now,
200 kilos out on the first attempt of Don
Opalogi. So, at the moment, the man in the bronze medal position is the Cameroon lifter, Dennis Asama, and Don Opalogi will come out to take his first attempt, and if successful at 200 kilos, and he's come down from his original opening proposed weight of 210, which is utterly sensible.
Totally, this is not about personal best right now. This is first and foremost, secure the gold medal. After that, do what you like.
So Don Opalogi, silver medalist 4 years ago at 85 kilos on the Gold Coast. This for the Commonwealth Games Championship of 2022 at 96 kilos. The Samoan cleans, jerks, and wins, and is the champion.
Wonderful performance from Don Opalogi, representing Samoa. He wipes the board with everybody on his first clean and jerk. That total is easily enough to win the title. Drives hard out of the clean. Look at the leg strength. Bar flies to arm's length. That is some wonderful lifting we have been witness to, and he still has two attempts remaining.
So he's got all the games records in the snatch, now in the clean and jerk, and the total. And now he can have some fun, so to speak. What it does mean is that congratulations to Vikas Thakur of India, who has secured the silver medal with 346, and to Taniela Rainibungi of Fiji, an excellent bronze, finishing on 343, a deserved medal for the Fijian. So the bar now up to 210 kilos.
Smiles all round for Team India with that silver medal. Dom Opolo, you're just trying to recover. He's breathing heavily still. It's 1:20 left on the clock, so he's still got time, but these kind of numbers do take a fair amount out of you, and trust me, 2 minutes following yourself is no time at all to recover. Smiles all round as well from Team Fiji.
Indeed, their man has historically just achieved the country's 15th Commonwealth Games medal. So Don fired up to give us a bit of an exhibition of weightlifting here. 210 kilos, more than double body weight. 200 was fantastic. We require another superlative for another great lift.
So much leg strength, so much leg power. A very tall guy, he does very well to get the bar so easily overhead on the jerk. If he can clean it, you've got to bet him jerking it. Not the tidiest to clean with the shoulders swinging a long way back, but the jerk is superb.
Well, he simply has to come out for the third attempt.
It would be rude not to, wouldn't it?
Well, for no other reason than his personal best in the clean and jerk is 210. So, come on, come and take another kilo or two or three or four or, as we've just seen, five.
Well, 215, scrap that. He's going to 220.
Oh my goodness.
I guess when it gets to these kind of numbers, you can't feel much difference between 210 and 220.
I think what's important to factor in is 23 years of age and the clean and jerk world record held by Tian of China is 231. So 220 is, well, it ain't shabby, that's for one thing. And by the way, Daniela Rainibongi for Fiji in winning the bronze medal here. That's the fifth weightlifting medal that Fiji have ever won at the Commonwealth Games. Well, they are really rocking in the stands behind us. Well, what a way to finish the men's 96 kilo final. 220 kilos on the bar. Another day. Samoa celebrates, and they will be in the early hours of the morning, as they are right here in Birmingham. And you didn't see it, but as the Lotus came on to the stage to prepare for the medal ceremony, every single one of the army boys was applauding Don Opologi.
Well, we've been witness to a truly special athlete here. I'm not sure which club he'll be in tonight, but there'll be some moves, I'm sure.
Don't worry, we're from my top, it's staying on. What an incredible session. Please stay with us as we will go shortly.
far there's not been a single competition so far that's lacked excitement, something special, something surprising, something dramatic.
I just don't know where the next competition is going to go to. I think we said that on day one. We started so strongly with so much excitement, and it's just been so much fun, so entertaining, and such strong competition.
Well, what's really good is when you see...
such a young age, how many more games does he have? How much more improvement can we see in this young man? And you know, from the early 20s, you've got to have a good few kilos left of improvement still.
Well, if your name is Opalogi, you have to deliver. Just to remind you, Eli Opalogi and Nusila Opalogi, double gold medals for them in the Commonwealth Games of Delhi in 2010. Then we went to Glasgow, where Eli Opalogi picked up a silver and Mary Opalogi picked up the bronze. Then Don in 2018 picked up the silver. Today's picked up the gold, and stand by for Jack tomorrow. There is confirmation by, well, the whole of the Pacific Ocean in terms of kilos. Don Opalogi has won the championship here, the Commonwealth Games gold medal in 96 kilos. Congratulations to Vikas Thakur and also to Taniela Rainibongi. And, well, Cyril Chachet II and Forrester Osai, well, it'll be another day for them. Well, just caught my breath. So, a competition that really had just about everything. Let's have a look at the highs and lows of the men's 96 kilo Commonwealth Games final. Well, just to reflect on Samoa, weightlifting and boxing have been the two sports where they've really succeeded over the years at the Commonwealth Games. It all began for Samoa in the world of weightlifting way back in 1974 in Christchurch, when Paul Warwick got the first medal, a silver in those games. And then, well, we had to wait a long time till 2010 in Delhi, when they picked up no less than three gold medals. And then the success continued. Glasgow, no golds, but two silvers and a bronze. And then to the Gold Coast in Brisbane, where Samoa succeeded not once, not twice, three, four times, five medals, in fact, in the Gold Coast.
So these are the three top performers. Silver, we've just seen Fiji's Ranenboa here in picture from India. Thakur, a total of 3-4-6. There we go, that's the 1-8-8 jerk. So 1-9-1 jerk. And here we go, Dan Opalogi from Samoa. 210 kilos for a clean sweep of games records. He finishes up with a 3-8-1 total.
Well, there's the party.
That's the pre-party, David. We're going to have the after-party very soon.
Well, I wonder what's happening in Apia, the capital. I reckon they'll all be up. They'll all be dancing there.
There's going to be some celebrations for that performance. There would have been a lot of eyes on him from his home country. Can you hear that back home? We've got some tunes going on here in this stadium. Wonderfully entertained from the Samoan contingent.
Well, here we go, the medal presentations for a terrific competition.
NEC One, please welcome the medalists.
The ceremony for the men's 96 kilo Commonwealth Games gold medal final here in Birmingham. Gold to Samoa, silver to India, bronze to Fiji.
Bronze medalist representing Fiji, Taniela Ranenboa.
Terrific performance by Taniela Ranenboa for Fiji. Years of age and 155 kilos in the snatch, 188 in the clean and jerk for 343. Absolutely clear and deserved of his bronze medal. Fifth weightlifting medal for Fiji in the history of their appearances in the Commonwealth Games. Third Commonwealth Games for Vikas Thakur, and a medal every time he's competed. Today, 155 in the snatch, 191 for a total of 346. And it'll be a happy journey back to the Punjab.
Gold medalist and Commonwealth Games champion representing Samoa, Dom Opalogi.
At 23, he has upgraded the silver from 4 years ago to gold in 2022. Dom Opalogi continues the dynasty of success in his family. Games records, 171 in the snatch, 210 in the clean and jerk, 381, and so much more to come. And watch out for this man when we get to Paris in 2024. And so, to recognize a spectacularly good winner, the anthem of Samoa.
Thank you.
Well, a fantastic performance by the Samoans on the stage in the shape and form of Don Opalogi, but an even brilliant performance from the Samoan choir behind us for the national anthem.
Sure, I had to take my headset off then just to appreciate the vocals that were going on here in the stadium.
Well, three great athletes, three terrific performances, and you can sense the satisfaction on their faces, all with medals, these medals designed by the School of Jewellery here in Birmingham and manufactured in the famous Jewellery Quarter, and glittering and shiny, and I hope you've enjoyed this competition. It's been absolutely super for a whole raft of reasons. And the quality of lifting here in the Commonwealth Games continues apace.
Well, it certainly does. And Dan Opalogi, just to put this in perspective, he's just won that category by 35 kilos, and it could have been more. That was a true spectacle that we were witness to.
Well, they can go off and enjoy themselves. I hope you've enjoyed watching. Thank you so much for your company. We really appreciate it. From Mikhaila Breeze and myself, David Goldstrom, for the moment, bye-bye from Birmingham.